In this video, we are going to deploy OpenStack Trove and the Tesora Database as a Service platform on an Ubuntu 14.04 Linux environment. Let's begin by logging into the Linux environment as an Ubuntu user. You can follow all these steps in our product documentation under the Ubuntu install steps. The first thing we're going to do is grant ourselves superuser access. Now let's add the OpenStack Kilo repository. To do that, we are going to install the Ubuntu Cloud Keyring. Next, we're going to update the sources file with the Kilo information. Once that's complete, we're going to update the Tesora Dbaas and the OpenStack distribution to make sure we have the latest packages. Once the latest Kilo packages are installed, we are going to access the Tesora Dbaas components. First, we'll get the Tesora APT repository key. We will now add Tesora to the APT sources. We will do another APT get update to ensure that we have the latest packages. Now that we have both the Kilo and the Tesora packages, we will go ahead with the installation. We will begin with an APT get install of the various Tesora packages. The first one to install will be the Tesora Dbaas API package. Once that is complete, we will install the Task Manager package. Next is the Conductor package. We will then install the Dbaas client package. And finally, we will install the Dbaas dashboard package. To run the dashboard, we also need to upgrade the memcached as well as the Python cached packages. Again, the product documentation also has the necessary steps to do this. To set up these two packages, we will use the apt get command again. Once that is complete, we will edit the OpenStack dashboard local settings py file under the etc data tree. We will set the OpenStack host value to controller, replacing localhost. Then we will ensure the allowed host value is set to everything. So in this case, we'll remove the extra comma and the extra space. For the memcached session storage service, we'll choose the Django value. The value will be commented out by default, so we'll uncomment it, and then we'll comment out this existing value. Now we will restart the web server and the session storage service. At this point, we've set up all our Kilo and Tesora packages. Next, we'll configure the Tesora Dbaas platform so it can communicate with the OpenStack environment. We'll need to set up certain values and parameters to tell the Tesora Dbaas platform where the various OpenStack services are running. The Tesora Dbaas platform install has provided a script to set up the values. That script is located under the OPT Tesora Dbaas bin data tree. This script will ask a number of questions to set up the communication between Tesora and OpenStack. The first prompt is for the MySQL host and port, which is normally running under the OpenStack controller environment. In this case, we will also use the default values for the MySQL user for Tesora Dbaas. If you want to change the values, you can do that here, but be sure to document those value changes. We will use the default for the Dbaas admin user, and once again, you can choose your own values here. We are going to use the Dbaas admin tenant for service, and for the region, we'll use the default value. If you have your own region where all the OpenStack services, such as Cinder, Swift, Nova, Glance, or Keystone are running, make sure you use the correct region here. We'll choose the Keystone admin URL in this case. Once we specify the server name for the Keystone admin URL, you can see that it now uses this value for the remaining services. Here, the Nova user is the default value admin. If it's a different value in your case, specify that. For Nova, we are going to use the admin tenant. The RabbitMQ host port runs on the same machine as the OpenStack controller on port 5672. By default, the RabbitMQ user has the value guest and the password is set to password. The value for the controller host or address reachable for guest instances should be the OpenStack controller value, so we'll specify that. It then asks if you want to create the Tesora Dbaas database. Here you will need the admin credentials for the MySQL server. Keep in mind that this setup script can be run multiple times. If you do not have all the credentials now, you can run the script with the credentials you do have, and then run the script again later with newer ones. The MySQL admin user is root, and the password is password. Next, we need to pass the Keystone admin user, which in this case is Nova. The Keystone password is password, and the Keystone tenant is service. Now we see that all of the services are running. Next, we need to set up our environment variables so we can run the different commands and verify that our Tesora, Dbaas, and OpenStack environments are available. We will create a simple input file that we can source. In this file, we will specify the username, password, tenant, and Keystone authentication URL. We will then source this file to avoid repeatedly entering the information. Now, with all the values configured, we can run the different commands and validate that the environment is working. So let's first make sure we can access the compute environment. Now let's make sure Cinder is available, because we need the block storage. Since it's a brand new environment, those values will be blank. Next, we can make sure the object store is available. Now let's obtain the Keystone user list to ensure that the Trove user we specified earlier was created. You can see that there is a user called Trove. The last thing to do is to verify that the Trove environment is available. Now let's make sure we can access the Nova flavors through Trove. And we can also do the equivalent of a Nova image list. We have not created any data stores yet, so this list is empty for now. You have now successfully deployed the Tesora Database as a Service platform.